Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. We're starting a new chapter today, Simin Kuf Tzadi, Dalid 194. Dine Geises Ushmiras Hameis. These are the laws of a Geises, a person that is dying, and guarding the deceased. These are some grim topics over here, things that people don't always like to speak about. We're learning them because they're in the Kitzur, and unfortunately, with all of the chaos of the last year, the coronavirus and the like, so many different things going on. Death is something that has become prevalent over the last 11, 12 months. And we wish and we pray that everybody should have health and strength. And you shouldn't know from these things, but since that this is part of the halachas, and perhaps sometimes it is something that is pertinent in a person's life, so therefore we're going to learn these laws as well. Ha-geises, a person whose death is imminent. Perush, what does that mean? Geises, ha-mala leicha b'groinim b'bnei tzaras echaza. How do you know if a person, their death is imminent? So in general, he says, a person has a lot of phlegm that they bring up into their throat because the tightness in the chest, they simply cannot breathe. And anyone that's ever been, God forbid, in a room where somebody is on their last breaths of life, they know that the breathing is very labored and it's very hard for them. And that's a geises. V'zeh yikras samach lamisa. This is called shortly before death. Lashon geises hu milashon megis b'kedera. Geises is from a lashon of megis, of stirring up the pot. What does that mean? Sh'aleicha mishapeches b'groinoi. Come on, megis b'kedera. The phlegm is turning over in his throat. Sigh for the imagery over here. Just as one stirs the pot. Now, harihu kechai l'kol dvar. Very important halacha. This person whose death is imminent, they're already breathing, they already have that breathing pattern which shows that it's not going to breathe forever. This person, you should know, he is treated like a living person in all the halachas, which means he's alive, and we have to be very careful at this point to make sure that we don't do anything that is going to hasten his death. Therefore, you're not even allowed to touch a person that is a geises. Shekola nageibo, because anyone who touches them, harizah shofech damim, you could be considered as if you're spilling blood. Why? Because touching a person who is laboring in their breathing, touching a person who's on their last leg of life over here, could end up hastening and speeding up the death, and therefore you brought death earlier. That is like shvichas damim. That is like killing them. The Mishnah says that even if a person, it appears that the last breath of life has escaped them, and their eyes were open, and you close their eyes. So closing the eyes could end up pushing out a little bit more of their life. That's also shvichas dam, and that's also spilling blood. What can we compare a geises to? Lener metavtev, it's like a flickering candle. When a person touches the flickering candle, and they put their hand over there by the wick, immediately it ends up going out, it's extinguished. Avabishu geises, and therefore the same thing over here. A geises is flickering, his life, his soul is flickering right now. You touch him, you put too much pressure on him, you move things around, you could end up causing him to extinguish his life. Avabishu geises man orach, even if the guy is a geises for a long time. It's great distress for him and for his relatives that are standing around. Mikol makom asa ligram shiyamos meri, you cannot cause his death any earlier and sooner. That's shvichas damim, that is killing. For example, he's got a pillow under him, or he has a quilt that's under him, and you want to move it out from over there. Machma shomer, because people tell you sheyesh noitzayis miktas oifoy shigarmin la'akeves hamisa, they have some perhaps superstitious ideas that there are feathers of certain birds that are in the pillow or the quilt that could end up delaying his death, so therefore his guy's suffering, so let's move it out. No, you can't, because by moving it, what's going to happen? You are going to be hastening his death. They thought that putting the keys of the shul underneath the head of the sick person over here would also make it an easier transition from this world to the world to come. By moving his head, lifting it up, putting the keys underneath, you are hastening his death. That's also asur. However, if there are things that are preventing the soul from leaving the world, someone's chopping wood outside the hospital room over here, and it's disturbing the geises, and unless he gets calm, he cannot go on to his, he cannot continue the journey into the world to come. In that case, Mutar La'asir, you can go and tell the wood chopper, stop chopping the wood, stop making so much noise. You're staring, you're bothering this person in here. The aim is a ma'aseh, because you're not doing any positive action over here by enhancing or by damaging his ability to live. But rather, all that you're doing over here is you're removing the noise that is there, which is preventing the geiseis from being able to go through a peaceful death. And since that you're not touching him, therefore, all of that is going to be permissible. Now, this is a much larger topic because it gets into procedures and surgeries and medications and the like, that a person who is a geiseis, who's really towards the end of life when the doctor wants to do things, it's a very, very big halachic shaila question of what is allowed to be done. And if a person finds themselves in that situation where they have someone that they are taking care of who is very ill, and the doctors want to do evasive or invasive or very serious procedures to him, and it's a question whether or not it's going to work, not going to work, it's going to prolong his life, not prolong his life, you need to make sure that you speak to your local Orthodox rabbi and ask the proper questions in order to do things in a halachic way in the end of life. As we see over here, it's so important, because every action and every move and every step that a person takes during this time, it could either be enhancing one's life, or God forbid, it could be considered shvichas damim, taking the life away. You should only know simchas and health and good things. Have a wonderful day.